This is a camera comparison between the Galaxy A51 and the S10E. Galaxy A51's camera is what Samsung is marketing the most, and I would really like to see how it stands next to Samsung's last year flagship device. The S10E has the same camera as the Galaxy S10 and the S10 Plus, so it would be really interesting to see what happens here. Before we begin, it would be massively appreciated if you can subscribe to my channel. First of all, we have the Galaxy A51 with the quad camera system at the back. It has a 5 megapixel depth camera with f2.4. Next in the camera array is a 48 megapixel Sony IMX582 sensor with f2.0. There is a 12 megapixels ultrawide camera with f2.2. And in the end, there is a 5 megapixels macro shooter with f2.2. The A51 has a 32 megapixels Sony IMX616 camera on the front. This phone is powered by Exynos 9611 chipset. On the other hand, the S10e houses a main 12 megapixels S5K3J1 sensor with f1.5 to f2.4 and a 16 megapixels ultrawide camera with f2.2. On the front, it has a single 10 megapixels camera with f1.9. It's also the same S5K3J1 sensor from Samsung. In this camera comparison, I have taken images in all the possible environments and all the common modes that are there on both these phones. Let's start the comparison without any further ado. Take a look at this 48 megapixels versus a 12 megapixels picture of the S10e. The only difference that I see here is that the A51 has slightly better details because of a bigger picture. Edge detection of the S10e is better. Both phones are managing the highlights and the shadows very well. Depth effect is also very good on both the sides. Now, this is a 12 megapixels picture of the A51 versus the same picture of the S10e. You can see that the 12 megapixels picture is as same as the 48 megapixels. Here is another outdoor picture. Now this time, the S10e has slightly sharp details whereas the A51 struggles. Picture on the S10e side also has better contrast and color composition. This is an ultrawide picture. I'm liking it on both the phones. A51's picture is on the warmer side and S10e has a cool tone for this picture. This is a normal picture and this is clearly better on the S10e. S10e's contrast is very good while the A51 is losing the colors and details. This is an 8x zoom picture from both phones and I find S10e's picture better. Since the A51 has a macro camera, here is the macro camera versus the normal close-up. Clearly the A51 is ahead here because of its dedicated macro shooter. Yet another outdoor picture, the S10e once again has deeper colors and its details are also better. This is another ultrawide picture. This time the A51 is giving a better feel. The details, however, are better on the S10e side here too. Take a look at the selfies now. The normal selfies have a warm tone on the S10e. Even the group selfies have a warm tone. The S10e is doing a slightly better job with the details. The normal selfies have a similar contrast, saturation, sharpness and the details. Even the live focus selfies have that slightly warm tint on the S10e side. I guess this is going to be your personal preference. I am personally liking the look of the A51 selfies, but the S10e selfies are what some users are going to like. I took a lot of selfies from different angles and the result was not any different. The beauty mode was working on both the phones. Live focus did a great job. I can safely say that both phones have impressive front cameras. Take a look at this ultrawide picture. The S10e is on the warmer side again and the A51 is having a cool tone. In the normal mode, the S10e is doing better with the saturation and the details. A51 also has a very good picture but not very good when it comes to the details. This is the rear camera's live focus from both the phones. Live focus is one of the most important features of these phones and it's doing its job perfectly well on both the sides. Now this yellow pony also has a difference on both the sides when it comes to the colors. I guess the S10e is doing this because of Samsung's own sensor. The picture is fine on the S10e side and doesn't look bad on the A51 side either. So far, the A51 is going head to head with the Galaxy S10e. This is a green bench in real. On the S10e side, its color is quite realistic, but on the A51 side, it has a bluish shade, and that's what I've been trying to explain, that it has a cool tone for some pictures. This is another picture to look at how these phones capture colors and details. A51's pictures have color depth in some areas. The S10e's colors are not as deep in this one. For instance, this picture also has a high contrast on the A51 side, but I will not say that it looks bad on the S10e side. That's just a different lens there. Now here, the dynamic range of the S10e is very good. A51 is giving it a tough fight as well. Zooming in shows further that the S10e is once again doing better with the details. Here is yet another bench, and this time it's under bright sunshine. The A51, in my opinion, has better details, while the S10e is not managing the highlights very well. Look at the orange and the green colors first. It once again has a yellowish tone on the S10e side. If we take a look at the background, the green table is again on the blue side on the A51 and tries to retain the colors on the S10e side. I guess if Samsung had used its own sensor in the A51, the results would not have been very different here. Look at my hands, all clear and good on the S10e, and it goes a little out of focus on the A51 side. This is yet another picture where I think the A51 has a better color tone, but it cannot really keep up with the shadows and the highlights at times. For example, the surface underneath these plants is more visible on the S10e's picture. Indoor picture, the S10e's picture is what's very close to the real environment. A51 is not doing good with the details once again in this ultra-wide picture. Overall, I am liking how the S10e is managing the exposure, the highlights and the shadows. The same picture through the normal camera mode, S10e once again is ahead. A51 is making my grey sofa look blue, and I'm not liking that. Even the cushions in the A51's picture are having super bright highlights. This is the picture that I add to all of my camera comparisons for the sake of judging the highlights, and it can be seen here that the S10e's highlights and details are just a tiny bit better. A51's picture is also good. This picture is meant to show you the edge detection, and I guess I don't need to say a word here. The A51 loses it when it comes to the edge detection. Cushion's color is close to real in the S10e's picture. Even the sofa looks good. If you like those boosted colors, you may go with the A51's picture. This is a very good picture on both the sides. Let me know which phone's white color do you like. Are you liking the S10e's picture with that sunshine or A51's cool picture? In this one, you can easily differentiate between the color capabilities of these phones. Colors are on the darker side in the A51's pictures, and they are slightly bright in the S10e's picture. Once again, the S10e has superior edge detection. Surprisingly, there is not a huge difference here. However, the background looks more detailed in the A51's picture. This is another set of ultra-wide, wide and zoomed in picture. Both phones are doing a superb job in their own capacity. I can't really choose a winner over the other. In some pictures, the A51 has better dynamic range and the S10e has better in some. It's time to take a look at the low light, non-night mode versus the night mode pictures. Galaxy A51's camera is designed to take better low light pictures, but unfortunately, the S10e beats it there. Even the night mode selfies on the S10e were superior. They brought in a subtle light, maintaining the smoothness, while the A51 selfies were on the rough side. Upon comparing the pictures taken with and without the night mode, I found that in all the pictures, the Galaxy S10e was capturing better details, and it was trying to keep all the things clear. The airports picture is where the Galaxy A51 went ahead with the details, but again, in the outdoor nighttime pictures, the S10E showed what a flagship's pictures look like. Take a look at the videos now. S10E has optical image stabilization and it can also shoot 60 frames per second videos in both the 4K and the 1080p resolutions. On the other hand, the Galaxy A51 does not support 60 frames per second. However, it can shoot 1080p and 4K videos. Also, the Galaxy A51 does not have any optical image stabilization. It has electronic image stabilization and that only works in the 1080p mode only. But in this comparison, I'm not going to show you the 60 frames per second from the S10e because this comparison is all about the common modes on both the phones. You will see videos in all the available resolutions and then see the front-facing videos too. This is the front video from the Galaxy A51 and the S10e. Both phones can capture the front videos in the 4K resolution. Right now you are watching this video in the 4K resolution. After this you will see the 1080p shots as well. Right now I am facing the sun, but I am going to show you around. Now this front video is being recorded in the 1080p resolution. One thing that I am liking about the Galaxy A51 is that it has a wider angle for recording the videos from the front cam. The result will be analyzed later on. However, you can definitely drop your choice in the comment section down below. And finally, it's time to conclude this video. First things first, you have seen all the pictures and you yourself can judge them better. As far as my own analysis is concerned, I personally don't find the Galaxy S10e's camera good enough to give up on the Samsung Galaxy A51. What I mean is Galaxy A51's camera is definitely inferior. It does not even have OIS and cannot do 60fps videos. But if we see it from an average user's perspective, its pictures look very good. Sony sensor provides that color boost to the pictures, taking them to a whole new level. And on the top of that, the Galaxy A51 can capture true 48 megapixel pictures. The S10e's camera is great, but then it has its price too. So if the Galaxy S10e is the winner here, the Galaxy A51 is not the loser either. With that said, I will sign off. Make sure to hit the subscribe button and I will see you in the next one really soon.